Well, first of all, I want to say something about something I read in the newspaper last year, because I'm also a founder of Women in Cybersecurity Foundation in Holland. Due to the lack of feminine role models, and also we'd like to have more women working in cybersecurity. So last year, all of a sudden, the Dutch newspaper hit an article saying you need to go to Bulgaria, because this is the number one country in Europe where about 30% of the women work in cybersecurity. I didn't know that. By then, I did not even know anyone here in Bulgaria. So when I read the article, I thought I really should go to Bulgaria. At first, I wanted to move here, but I thought maybe I should go and visit it to begin with and explore what's going on. So even if I'm here to tell you something about the apps and the lack of breaches in it, or the breaches in it, I just wanted to say to you, the people in Bulgaria, you're doing a tremendous job by having 30% women working in IT security. I think this is a great example to the rest of Europe, and I think also to the rest of the world. So, I'm here to tell you something about the Internet of Things and the Internet of Toys, and also the things that worries me. I brought a cheat sheet because 2 weeks ago I was invited to Malaysia to tell something about the subject, and they also told me you have 10 minutes, and after 30 minutes I saw someone waving at the back, and because I know so much of the subject, you know, I can talk about it for hours. So I brought my cheat sheet. So, how is cyberspace affecting peace and security? Well, my answer to that is by apps. Because nowadays, everyone is carrying their mobile phones with it. Even the latest investigations or research show that we look at our phones every 4.5 minutes. It used to be every 6 minutes. So if you calculate it, you will sleep for hopefully 8 hours. That means about more than 2,000 times a day. So it's not only because you like to see what kind of weather it will be in Sofia. Obviously, it's always nice here. It's also because of all the apps that are stored on the phone. Back in the days, I see some young people here. I'm 43, so back in the days at the office, you had a radio, a television, even a voice recorder, and they were, I think you remember the big things, but nowadays everything is just in your telephone. It's all run through apps. But I investigated most of the apps with the platform Internet of Toys, and I will tell you later why it's called the Internet of Toys. It's not because we're playing every time, because we did research on toys that are connected through the internet, and especially the apps they use. And then we found out that most of the apps can be breached. So back in the days when we had the radio and the television, it was normal to just walk around, do stuff. So nowadays, you get away with hitting your phone every 4.5 minutes, and everything is replaced on your phone by the things we have now there on your phone, right? So even today, getting more smarter with smart devices, I think it makes people more stupid. For example, and I must look at Jordan, I don't know if it's possible to upload a short presentation to the website later so I can show the pictures to everyone. I run it to a barbecue, and it was run by an app. And to point out that we're getting more stupid by this all new technologies, this barbecue was run by an app. And the funniest thing is that you should put a, I think it's a small wire inside the meat, and then you press the app on your phone, and the app will tell you what kind of meat is on the barbecue. I think this is strange, because back in the days, you just either touched it or, I don't know, maybe tasted it, and now we just ask an app what kind of meat is on the barbecue, right? But not only that, we found out that the app could be manipulated. So I don't know how this is in Sofia. I really have nice neighbors, but sometimes they have small kids running around and screaming. And if I found out they're having a barbecue, I would just like to press the app, you know, in order to make sure that their meat is gonna, I don't know, end up black or red, whatever you like to. So this is one of the examples of an app that is connected to a device. I also saw a device called it's an air conditioning. And people wear it in Asia, in calls. At the mine, sorry. It's run by an app, and the app will tell you, it's an air conditioning, right? I see you looking, it's an air conditioning you wear through your waist. And the app will tell you either if you're hot or if you're cold. And the air conditioning will be turned on or turned off because the app will tell you so. We also found out that that app could be breached. So in order to make sure you make someone angry, you just touch the app and make sure the person who's wearing the portable air conditioning, I don't know, will either be very warm or hot. So this is another thing why I think with all the devices, people are getting more stupid, because how come an app will tell you whether you're hot or you need to go outside for some fresh air? It's really stupid. So the latest thing is a vacuum cleaner. It's from a specific brand. I don't know if I can say the name of the brand because I'm not fond to a lawsuit, so I'll just call it another vacuum cleaner. But it has a camera inside. So if you have a look around your own house or maybe office today, you should think and look at all the devices you are having. Most of them are now, because it's a hype, carrying cameras inside. I don't know what's going on. Why should there be a camera in my fridge or in my doorbell? I can imagine, but I don't understand the camera in my robot. So this specific vacuum cleaner with the camera inside got breached. And you could take pictures and make some movies in someone else's house. And it got breached through an app. And then maybe you think, well, what's fun about taking other people's pictures or making movies in someone else's house? Well, the new thing in England, and I think we talked about it yesterday, right, Koen, is domestic violence. So last year, there were about 1,000 people who came up with a lawsuit because they felt battered. So normally, we used to call that cyberbullying, right? But now the new thing is cyber violence. So in order to make sure your ex-wife or husband or someone you like to, I don't know, piss off, can I say this in Sofia? Yeah. You make sure you have, for example, a thermostat, and that's run through an app. So whenever you finish the relationship, don't remove the app. Go outside and touch the app and try to heat up the house just for bullying. So the new thing about the apps and the use of apps and also the breaches within it is domestic violence. I tried to come up with numbers if this is common in Bulgaria, but there was no one who could tell if this is a thing in Bulgaria. But if it's not a thing, maybe it's gonna be a thing, but this is now spread worldwide, the violence or domestic violence by the use of or misuse of apps. So another thing about apps is that we use apps for communication purposes. You can either use WhatsApp or Kik, for example. If you see someone using Kik, you should be worried, because this is an app that is used by pedophiles. In Holland, we use WhatsApp, and I've heard here in Bulgaria, you use Viber a lot, right? I see people nodding. Yeah, can I see some hands? Who's using Viber? Okay, so it's, yes. What you gonna tell me? Okay, here's the thing. About a month, I think 6 months ago, Facebook was all in the news about the way they got your data, stored your data, sent it and sold it to third parties. But for you here out there who are using Viber, I have a strong message for you. Viber could do the same thing. I'm not saying they are, because I would like to leave the country tomorrow. So I'm just saying they could if they would, right? So this is what I found out. So here comes my cheat sheet. Sorry. If you install the app on your phone, this is what you actually gaining or telling Viber they can do on your phone. They're gaining access through all of your contacts. They're gaining access through all of your media files and photos. They're also allowed to make phone calls or see who's been calling you. And they can also record audio. It's also possible when you use fiber that they are allowed to take pictures and allowed to make videos, even if you're not around the phone, even if you're not using it. And also they will track you because they will track the location where you've been around. So the good news is that you can do something about it. So I try to ask Fiber, what's going on? Why are you getting all this information just because I want to use your app? So they send me a privacy agreement, and this is what it said. And I will read it out loud because otherwise you think I make it up. Right? This is their official statement. Fiber can only receive the public information on your social network accounts. This information will only be passed to us when you connect your account. We won't receive it again. Okay, this sounds okay, right? But then, this information includes your name, profile image, and any other details you provide in the public section of your account. So that means, because I had the conversation, if you use Fiber, it automatically connects to your Facebook account, if you are running a Facebook account also on your telephone. So that means they can see every like you ever published, they can see every picture you ever post, and they can see whoever you've been calling, right? So the good news is you can change your Fiber settings. It's very easy. I'll be walking around afterwards. You can ask me, I can show you, because I installed Fiber on my phone just to make sure I will not be telling you lots of untruth stories. So what's next? I think more breaches are to come because the world is getting more smarter, and therefore, I'm sorry to say so, people are getting more stupid because they rely on their devices and they rely on their apps. So in order to address the question about how is cyberspace affecting peace and security, I think the answer lies in the use of apps. So please make sure whenever you're installing another app or try to buy a vacuum cleaner or something with a camera inside or something that's connected through the internet, even if it's a phone or a doll or, I don't know, a vacuum cleaner or a refrigerator, whatever is connected to the internet, it's very, very easy to be breached. And I've shown it in Holland, and they don't like me for it, but I'm still doing it. This is why I have the platform Internet of Toys, because toys are more easy to hack than devices such as refrigerators. So my message to you out there here in Sofia, be careful by the use of apps. Make sure if you run about 50 apps, because this is the average amount of apps that people have on their phone, but you only use 4. So make sure that you will remove, before you leave the hotel, the other 46 you don't use. And if you don't trust your phone or you want some advice, I'll be here until tomorrow morning, 6 o'clock. So send me a message, knock on my door, or have some coffee later. Thank you.